Hello children, good morning everyone. Hope you all are keeping fine. Children, today from your history book, we are going to do chapter number 5, and that is the Muslim League. Children, in the previous two chapters, first phase of national movement and second phase of Indian national movement, we have seen that both Hindus and Muslim, they work together in unity for the independence of the nation. Now in this chapter, we will study how the Muslims separated themselves from others to form the Muslim League. There were many reasons for doing that, and then how British took advantage of all this and how British had created problem between Hindus and Muslims. So children, we'll start with the growth of communalism. When people feel about being of different religion. So the Hindus and the Muslim had lived together in India for centuries, for many years. Since both of the communities were exploited by the British, they fought together during the First War of Independence, and even after the First War of Independence was over, in the first and second phase of movement, they both were united together against the British imperialism. The uprising of 1857 made the British realize that they had to divide the two communities to order to prolong their rule in India. They thought if both Hindus and Muslims were live with unity, then it will be difficult for the British to rule India. That's why they planned to divide them on the basis of religion. It was the British policy of divide and rule that led to the rise of communal trend and to formation of Muslim League in 1906. So children, there were many factors that led to the formation of Muslim League. There are many factors. It is given in your book also. Change in this attitude of British policy of divide and rule. So all this were the cause or the factor that led to the division of Muslim League. First of all, children, the British established the supremacy of India, and after that the Mughal rule were put to the end. Therefore, the Muslim became bitter enemies of the British. They participated in the Wahhabi movement, which aimed to end British domination in India. And then children, the divide and rule policy was that the British became apprehensive to the safety and stability of their empire in India. They saw that unity was there between Indian and Muslim, so they had an idea to divide them. So there were many ways how they divided Muslims and Hindus. In 1871, Lord Mayo, the government adopted a resolution which made Urdu the media of instruction for Muslim in primary and secondary education, and increased government aid to educational institute run by Muslim. So you know that there were two communities, Hindus and Muslims. Now British started giving favor to Muslim, and so that Hindus may feel deprived of the advantage that was given to Muslim. So Hindus will think that Muslims are British are doing favor to Muslim and not to Hindus. And then they tried to create hatred among the Hindus and Muslim by portraying Muslim ruler as plunderers and Hindu rulers as cruel king in their Muslim for the Muslim subjects. So for both, for Hindus and Muslims, they were doing the same thing. Once they were showing that the Muslim invaders or Muslim rulers, they were plundering India, and Hindu rulers as the cruel ruler who were not doing good for the subject, Muslim subject in their dynasties. So this way they created enmity between Hindus and Muslims. They tried to justify the partition of Bengal by convincing the Muslims that Bengal was being partitioned to create a new Muslim majority province where the Hindus will not be able to subvert their interest. Then they tried to utilize their caste structure to turn the non-Brahmins and the lower caste against high caste. So here The main motive was to divide them on the basis of religion. They tried to spread communal hatred through the press, poster, literature and public platform. So these were the factors that created differences between Hindus and Muslims. Second one was the relative backwardness of Muslim community at education, trade and industry. Children, here also Muslims were backward class at that time, means the Hindus were more educated than the Muslims were. Very few Muslims were educated in Western system of education. Muslim weren't recruited in civil and military services. Muslim weren't involved in any organized industries or business. Muslim didn't get government jobs as compared to Hindus who adopted themselves to the Western style of education. Now, the Hindus, most of them were educated in Western education. They got jobs in the government and they other privileged. They enjoyed other privileged. But the Hindu Muslims were quite backward. They were not educated much. And the British government in India had constantly discriminated against the Muslim after 1858. The Muslim community was not much involved in the growth of any organization industry. So here they were lagged behind. Even the Muslims were not highly educated. Not everyone, some were educated, but most of them were not educated. Some members of Muslim community did not keep up with the modern trend in social and cultural sphere. They were lagging behind because they were following the old culture, old tradition. They were not going together with the Hindus, whereas the Hindus, they changed themselves according to the modern trends. In these circumstances, it was quite easy for the British official to incite the Muslim against the Hindus. Now, Muslims saw that the Hindus were getting good jobs in government, whereas Muslims were not getting. So they had again, they were jealous of Muslims and Hindus, and there the seed of enmity grew between the true community. Then relative backwardness of Muslim community in education, trade and industry. Very few Muslims were educated in Western system, children. Muslims weren't recruited in civil and military service. Muslims weren't involved in any organized, this I have already done, children. So this is the way how the difference grew between Hindus and Muslims. One of the greatest leader of this community was Sir Sayyid Ahmad. He belonged to the Muslim community, as you can see in the picture. The role of Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, Aligarh politics. He was a great educationist and social reformer. He was great and he regarded Hindus and Muslims to be one nation. He founded the Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College at Aligarh and had both Hindu and Muslim patrons. Chilia, when Indian National Congress was founded, Sir Sayyid Ahmad opposed it. He founded the United Indian Patriotic Association in 1888, mainly with a view to oppose the Congress. Now, he was the first one to oppose the Congress. In this effort, he was supported by Mr. Baik, the British principal of Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College, Aligarh. Baik's idea was that Anglo-Muslim unity was possible, but Hindu-Muslim unity was not possible. So, because there were difference in views of Hindus and Muslims, he thought that they cannot work together. When the Indian National Congress was founded by Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, opposite. So, here Sir Sayyid Ahmad was totally against the British. It was said that Sir Sayyid Ahmad believed that since the Hindus formed the majority of Indian population, they would dominate the Muslim. The main idea of not supporting the Hindus was only this. The major cause was this. The Muslim thought, these Muslim leaders, they thought that the Hindus were in majority, so they will not be able to survive if they will unite themselves with Hindus. So children, till here we are doing today. Later on, chapter is quite big. We will take the other class. In other class, we will take forward the chapter. By the time you read chapter and take care of yourself, have a good day, children.